Well, many people, like myself, like the convenience of a drone, but they don't want the complications associated with them. This drone can be used with a controller or goggles, but let's throw them away in this video because I'm not interested. I want to focus on the word simplicity, and can we get some good footage just by using the onboard features? So let's go. The Neo has got 6 standard accessible flight modes just with a press of a button.
Circle.
Circle, again self-explanatory.
Rocket.
Rocket, and that's a bird's eye mode where the drone just goes straight up, takes a photograph or some video going up and video coming down.
Spotlight.
Spotlight, now that's an interesting one and I use that quite a lot. That's the drone hovering on a fixed axis, and as it tracks you, the drone moves left to right. So it doesn't actually follow you or move off this axis. It's literally a tripod in the sky. So how does this work? Does it work on subject tracking, GPS? Well, it's got some, obviously, AI in the bottom here. But what I found, it does track the human profile. It won't track a dog, it won't track a car. And if you're wearing something which isn't contrasty to the environment, for example, I was wearing a camo jacket in a field and it wouldn't track me. So if you're using this, try and wear some clothes which are contrasty to where you're doing the filming, and it will track you and do everything it should perfectly.
Droney, circle. Rocket. Spotlight.
Let's try the spotlight mode.
Spotlight. 3, 2, 1.
And as you can see there, it's quite windy. So this is following me on a fixed axis. It's still got me, even at a bit of a distance. This is like a little ninja, this thing. It's just eager to please. 12 miles an hour. Oh, I can still hear it's there. Whoa. Well, little ninja, you've done a great job there. So the custom modes are helix, boomerang, and object tracking. And that's set by your phone through the app. So when you're using the drone as a standalone, it will remember what the phone app is set at.
Direction track.
Direction track, now that's one of the first custom modes. That's when it will track you from whatever position it takes off from. If it takes off in this position, it will track you backwards. If it takes off in this position, it will track you sideways. Come on. It's fighting against the wind. So let's overtake it now and see what it does. Come on, droney, let's do it. Let's, come on. It didn't like that, did it? It didn't like that. This platform is nothing new, is it? Because Hover Air bought out the Hover Air X1 a little time back. But what DJI have done, they've put their own spin on it. They've put some of their own features onto the said platform. So what do I use this DJI Neo for? Well, basically, I use it just for B-roll, for quick shots. I've seen a lot of videos out there going through the full specs of this drone, and I suggest you go and watch them because they're very interesting. But for me, I want it to be simple, quick B-roll, job done, get on with the video. People were talking about it being cinematic, the footage. No, I don't think it is cinematic because it's a small camera, but it's perfectly adequate for doing the social media stuff, what we do. One feature I'm yet to test is the voice activation. So when it's connected to your phone via the DJI Fly app, you can use voice commands such as, hey fly, circle, hey fly, droney. That'd be an interesting one to test out. But again, you need to have it connected to your phone while doing this. So I'm not a massive fan of it at this stage. So just quickly, does this DJI Neo better the original Hover Air X1? Well, I think it does in several ways, but the main thing with the Hover Air X1, it folded in half. So it was really, really portable. But on the other hand, the Hover Air X1 was over £400, where this is £169, and that comes with one battery. I'd suggest you buy some extra batteries if you're planning on using this full time. But for me, one battery is great for an outing, quick shots, back in the car. It really is just a set it and forget it drone. You don't have to think about it too much. And I think that's why it appeals to me, because it's ease of use. There's no memory card feature on the Neo. It's got 22 gigabyte of onboard storage. So in 4K, that's probably about 40 minutes, which I think is good enough. Well, in a nutshell, I think the DJI Neo offers great functionality, great value for money, and it can get you those shots you never thought you'd perhaps get. But I've got something else coming up on the channel very soon. I'm gonna be testing a new drone from Hover Air. This is called the Hover Air X1 Pro, and it's got some really cool features, so stay tuned to watch my future video on the Hover Air X1 Pro. If you want to see more in-depth Skill School videos, it would be great if you become a part of our community. If this video has brought you any entertainment or value, I've put a video in the top corner I think you may like.